the first example for the first order reaction. The decomposition of the hydrogen peroxide in aqueous solution, hydrolysis of ester in acid medium, inversion of cane sugar or hydrolysis of sugar in acid medium, and radioactive disintegration. Next, we are moving to the individual example in detail. First is the decomposition of the hydrogen peroxide. So the hydrogen peroxide decomposed to form H2O plus oxygen. So the reaction constitute within a two steps. First is the decomposition of the hydrogen peroxide to form the water and nascent oxygen. It is a very slow reaction. Next is the nascent oxygen is highly unstable, so it combined together and we will get the oxygen molecule. Since the reaction consisting of this two step, the rate of a reaction is only depend upon the slowest reaction. So what will be the rate? Rate is equal to dx by dt, that's equal to k into concentration of the H2O2. Then this follow first order reaction, that's why the integrated rate expression for this reaction is equal to k is equal to 2.303 divided by t into log a by a minus x. But in the case of this hydrogen peroxide is a liquid, H2O is an again liquid, oxygen is a gas. So in order to determine the concentration of the hydrogen peroxide experimentally, we usually take the hydrogen peroxide in the Kohlenicke flask and titrate the solution hydrogen peroxide by using KMnO4. So from the initially we will titrate with by using KMnO4, we will get the initial concentration of the hydrogen peroxide in terms of volume. And after the completion of the reaction, we are also take the volume of the KMnO4 used for the completion of the reaction. So our equation become K is equal to 2.303 divided by T into log. Here in case of A, it is replaced by V0. V0, it is the volume required to valence or required to neutralize the KMnO4. Neutralize the H2O2 for the decomposition of the H2O2 KMnO4. So we will get the initial concentration of H2O2. Then after the completion of the reaction, we will again get a volume used for the neutralizing the H2O2 by KMnO4. So that is the VT. So the equation become K is equal to 2.303 divided by T into log V0 divided by VT. Since all the reagent, the concentration term involved only the liquid reacted. Next, we are moving into ester hydrolysis. Ester in presence of acid, we will get acid and alcohol. We can also do this experiment by using base catalyzed reaction. So the second reaction are the reaction hydrolysis which is taking place in the presence of base. The above reaction are the same reaction which is taking place in the presence of acid. So both the mechanism of the both acid and base catalyst are the different. Anyway, we are not discussing that mechanism. Anyway, the ester is a liquid, carboxylic acid is a solid, and then alcohol is again a liquid. So as we discussed earlier, we can use the same equation in the ester hydrolysis, that is the K is equal to 2.303 divided by T into log V0 divided by VT. Here I am stressing one more point. The ester hydrolysis is a first order reaction if you are not bothering the concentration of water. And that's why we are call it as pseudo first order reaction. The same reaction we will find out in the case of second order reaction. In that case, the concentration of the water is very relevant. So this same example, ester hydrolysis, we can use in three places. In the example for first order reaction, example for pseudo first order reaction and example for the second order reaction. But only the difference is that for if you are mentioning the ester hydrolysis for a first order reaction, the concentration of the water has no role in the rate of a reaction. Similarly, in the case of pseudo first order reaction. But if you are mentioning this example in a second order reaction, we should mention the concentration. The concentration of the water has a relevant role in the rate of a reaction.